Hello, Crespo here. I'm here to tell you about the recent discovery of a new family of materials, a family that is not yet well known, but with properties never seen before. I'm talking about topological insulators. Industry, medicine, the energy sector, microelectronics, aerospace, novel materials are not only important due to their numerous applications, but also because they are critical to the development of the discipline which studies them, condensed matter physics. It's surprising how many people know, for example, what high energy physics is about, but when you talk about condensed matter, they have no idea. Basically, condensed matter physics seeks to understand the properties of matter around us, mostly solids, but also liquids. Since matter is composed of atoms, and these atoms contain electrons that only obey the laws of quantum mechanics, this discipline studies the quantum behavior of these electrons when atoms come together, and how this behavior determines the final properties of the material. Moreover, condensed matter physics seeks new materials with unique properties and, who knows, which may be useful someday. In contrast, whilst high-energy physics aims to discover the laws that govern the universe at its most fundamental level, condensed matter physics searches for non-elemental phenomena, phenomena which arise from the complexity of nature, from the interaction of their fundamental parts. These unexpected phenomena are called emergent properties. Graphene is an example of a material with emergent properties, but we are not going to talk about that here. Let's continue with the topological insulator. To understand its rarity, we have to understand its band structure. Three important elements. 1. The valence band, where electrons live. They cannot move because there are as many electrons as quantum states available. They can ascend to another band if they have enough energy, but they can never be in 2. The gap, a forbidden area for the electrons. You will never find one there. But if an electron has enough energy, it can reach 3. The conduction band, where electrons have empty quantum states, so they can move freely through the material in the form of electric current. Important, among other things, the size of the gap determines the conductivity of the material. A large gap, you have an insulator. A small or null gap, you have a conductor. As you may have guessed, a topological insulator is an insulator, has a big gap, but it's a very peculiar insulator because its electrons are under a strong spin-orbit interaction, a relativistic phenomenon. This interaction makes some states of the conduction band exchange position with some of the valence band. So what? Well, inside the material nothing happens, but on the surface it is another story. We have said that the states do not exist in the gap, but on the surface of insulators, this rule is often broken. These states are offspring or descendants of interior states, that is to say, they belong to the family of valence or conduction. And here is the problem with topological insulators. Because some members of the family have been exchanged, the surface states inextricably join those families, that is, the valence and conduction bands. Furthermore, these states always come in conjoined pairs, each state with its opposing spin, Cramer's theory. Ultimately, these states permit the emergence of pairs of electrical current along the surface of the material, where they flow with reverse direction and spin. This is called ellicity. The interesting thing is that these currents are unstoppable. They are very difficult to modify. We will see why in the simple case of two-dimensional materials. Firstly, we see that the direction of the currents is restricted by the electron's spin. It is impossible for an electron to change direction. It's like having a two-way highway with one huge restriction. You cannot turn around. And secondly, these materials are topologically protected. That is, their properties do not change when we gently deform the material. Let's use an analogy. Imagine we have a band with a twist, like this. Now imagine we want to undo the twist just with movements, without revolving the band. Turns are prohibited. What you'll discover is that no matter how many moves you do, you can never remove the twist just moving the band, even with the most unusual paths. Something similar happens in the case of topological insulators. In a common insulator, we observe in some cases there are also currents on the surface. But if you start deforming the material, you can see how these currents disappear. Moreover, these currents are very unstable. We can see it by folding the band in half. Although you get two twists, which symbolize two currents, they do not stay long, they are not stable. The opposite occurs with the topological insulator. Its properties are like the single twist in the band. No matter how deformed the material is, within certain limits, its properties remain intact. In conclusion, we have a material that has electric currents where the electrons cannot change direction. This translates into a current with an intensity that does not fluctuate, a constant intensity. Moreover, even if the material were to be corrupted or contaminated, because of the topological protection, we can ensure that these currents will remain constant. Come on, a material that always has the same intensity? I'm sure it will have great applications in electronic. But how do you find these materials? How do you discover which solids behave like topological insulators? The key is finding a property relatively easy to measure, quantum conductance. The conductance measures the ability of a material to pass an electric current through it with ease. When we work with big things, we can see how the conductance is proportional to the geometry of the material. I mean, if we change the length of the material gradually, you can see how its conductance also changes gradually, leaving a perfectly continuous range of values. Or so it seems, because when we start to measure small things, everything changes. A good way to see it, it's separating delicately two contacts. Although you are not directly observing it, you are slowly separating a string made of a few atoms, finally separating them completely. What you manage to measure is that the conductance only takes specific discrete values. In short, conductance is quantized. We can observe the same effect in two-dimensional topological insulators. The big difference is that they don't need to be extremely small. A macroscopic specimen exhibits quantum conductance. Thus, in 2007, the first two-dimensional topological insulator was discovered, predicted theoretically in 2005, a complex of mercury telluride layers and cadmium telluride layers. Now, researchers around the world seek the next two-dimensional topological insulators. They are starting to see these effects in bismuth, and there are already predictions for others, like graphene and silicon. In fact, in the Universidad Autónoma de Madrid are conducting investigations with two-dimensional crystals of bismuth, layers with the thickness of an atom, and they have found evidence that these layers behave as a two-dimensional topological insulator. In their experiments, they try to exfoliate a layer of bismuth with a STM tip and test if this presents quantum conductance. So far, the result seems to tell us that they are going well, but more accurate measurements are still needed. Topological insulators are very young materials, they have a long journey ahead of them until we understand all their characteristics. We have not been able to talk much about three-dimensional topological insulators, a family that grows every day with new members and fascinating properties. People speculate about exotic particles on their surface, great applications in spintronic devices, and the discovery of new types of topological insulators, results of the study of new topologies and interaction between the electrons in them. We will closely follow its progress. And as always, thanks for watching!